And now, for the nation's number one gospel singing group, the Fantastic Violinettes from Detroit, Michigan.
Well, I got you a question at this time. Are you ready?
Children, are you ready? Children, are you ready? Children, are you ready? Are you
highlighting the life and career of one of gospel's greatest groups, the legendary Robert Blair and the Fantastic Violinettes. The Violinettes were formed in Detroit, Michigan, in 1952, when Willie Banks of the Evangelist Gospel Singers of Alabama moved to the Motor City and met Isaiah Lil Shot Jones, Wilson DeShields, and Leo Coney. Seeking to organize a quartet in the style of the Evangelist Gospel Singers, the foursome added Providence Thomas of the Singing Sons and began appearing locally as the Violinettes. Arthur Bob Beatty, another early member of the group and also known for his work with the Heavenly Gospel Singers and Sensational Nightingales, told radio announcer Mark Lindy in 2006 that the Violinettes got its name from seeing an image of a bass violin on the front cover of a music book. The Violinettes' first single, The Hauntingly Mournful Another Soldier Gone, was recorded by Detroit music entrepreneur Joe Von Battle in 1953, and leased to the local Drummond label. The single introduced even more listeners to Lil Shot's hair-raising falsetto voice, when a year later, Los Angeles-based Swing Time Records released the track for the R&B market, under the nom de plume of the Question Marks. Perhaps emboldened by the crossover popularity of Another Soldier Gone, the Violinettes tried their hand at singing R&B. The quartet, now consisting of Jones, DeShields, Coney and Calvin Fair, newly recruited from the L&N Gospel Singers, recorded two discs as the Gales for Von Battle's JVB label in 1955. Neither record attracted significant notice at the time. Another link in the chain between the Violinettes and R&B was added in 1957, when a young Wilson Pickett briefly joined the group. Pickett's lead on Sign of the Judgment for Gotham Records presaged the shout-style singing he would employ on his 1960s soul hits, such as Mustang Sally. The Violinettes' recording career took off after they signed with Checker Records in 1964. Some of the group's hits from their Checker period, most notably Old Time Religion, Stand By Me, If We Never Meet Again and Three Pictures of the Lord, remain in its repertory a half century later. By this time, a reconstituted Violinettes, with Jones, DeShields and Coney as the anchors, introduced Robert Blair as its newest lead singer. If Blair's high tenor evoked the falsetto of Lil Shot, his ability to sing with a preacher's intensity ensured that the quartet would remain relevant in an era when hard-singing quartets dominated gospel music. The group's penetrating treble harmonies made such an impact on the genre that gospel quartets emulate it today. During this time, the group consisted of Charles Brown, Cleophas Tillman, James Byers, James McCurdy, Leo Coney, Robert Blair, Robert Wilson, Lil Shot Isaiah Jones, and Wilson DeShields. During their time on Checker Records, they recorded several albums, which includes Stand By Me, 1965, self-titled Fantastic Violin Airs, 1966, I'm Going to Serve the Lord, 1967, Live the Right Way, 1968, Shout, 1968, In Concert, 1968, God's Creation, 1969, At His Command, 1970, and Groovin' with Jesus, 1971. The Violin Airs may well have recorded and sold more records than all the other groups represented here collectively. They were a leader in developing the sound of the 70s gospel groups, and their albums for Jewel and Chess Checker are highly recommended. Stan Lewis released a large quantity of soul and gospel on his Jewel Records, based in Shreveport. Otis Redding's Good to Me is a revered soul classic, and rightly so. They remained on the gospel charts constantly until early 1970. Keith Richards and Mick Jagger of the Rolling Stones also wrote for the group during that time. They have been very fortunate in recording for some of the top labels in the industry. In 1972, they recorded for Jewel Records. In 1983, they recorded for Malico Records, under the leadership of the late Frank Williams. In 1988, they moved to Atlanta International Records, AIR, where they recorded one of their biggest selling records, The Pink Tornado, which again made the record charts nationwide. In 1992, they recorded for Paula Records. There they showcased the spectacular talents of Danny Walker's Fantastics, a solo album featuring the Violin Airs. The Violin Airs have showcased many talents, and many groups have formed within the ranks. Jesse McDaniel left to form his own group, and the popular Everettys with Jerome and Freddie Williams all sang with the Violin Airs. Down through the years, the group have performed at all types of musical gatherings, from church concerts to jazz festivals throughout the United States. They have also performed at major concert halls and civic centers with such gospel greats as Shirley Caesar, Reverend James Cleveland, and the Mighty Clouds of Joy, to name a few. They have also performed with Sam and Dave, the Manhattans, and other popular music artists. The group has gone through several name changes, from the Violinaires, the Fantastic Violinaires, the Violinaires featuring Robert Blair, Robert Blair and the Violinaires, to Robert Blair and the Fantastic Violinaires. No matter what name was used by the group, there was one constant: the incomparable falsetto background and lead singers. The group never lost their ability to take harmonizing to a level that would rarely, if ever, be matched by any other group. Some of the group's most noted recordings were Dr. Jesus, I Got So Much to Shout About, Three Pictures of the Lord, A Simple Prayer, I Don't Know What This World Is Coming To, Coming Up Through the Years, The Lord's Prayer, and Children Are You Ready? Many of the group's early recordings are still being played on the airways today.
When praises go up, blessings come down. Oh, how merciful.
The Lord saw fit to call home Lil Shot, Isaiah Jones, Leo Coney, Reverend Charlie Brown, Robert Blair, Jesse McDaniel, Mr. James McCurdy, J.C. Smith, drummer Gregory Bobo Harris, and several other members are gone on, but the Violinaires will always be remembered as the group with an unmatched harmony. They are truly gospel legends.
I promise you, Father.